Hey YouTube fam, this is CTTKTC19812 back in my kitchen, the most world famous washing machine on the internet. Nice video that I'm going to make today. I'm going to ramble. I have no idea where this is going to go or even how to start it, but basically airbrushing. I've always wanted to kind of learn how to airbrush. I'm afraid of it. I don't consider myself a great painter, but it's a great skill. I think it would be amazing to have that skill with armor building. And believe it or not, I have a reason to want to learn how to airbrush because I'm going to need to learn how to airbrush. But we'll talk about that another time. So this video is for basically anybody who wants to learn to airbrush, knowing absolutely nothing about airbrushing. I started doing some research on all the forums from costume building, different forums. I've been YouTubing airbrushing videos, and this is what I've got so far. I had to buy an airbrush kit, and I bought one on Amazon. It was like 70 bucks, and somebody told me that's not strong enough for what you need. It only puts out 20, 25 pounds of pressure. You're going to need something a little heavier. Get a pancake compressor and this airbrush gun. I said, okay. So the first thing I did was buy the airbrush gun, and that's what came in first. So I'm going to show you that first. This is what they told me to buy. I believe it's called a Posh series. So I've learned that airbrushes can be two types. Gravity fed, which is when the paint cup is up on top and it's fed by gravity. Or siphon fed, where you have these bottles and it's fed from underneath. And there are pros and cons to both. It seemed like most of the really good painters happen to be using the top one, but there was other good guys that were saying there's a better reason to even use this one. What I like about this gun is that I actually have the ability to use it as a siphon and put the cups down here, or with this cup, you can see it's got that curve. If I plug it in here, it's still a gravity feed, but it's on the side. And what's good about it being on the side is that when I paint, there's nothing obstructing my view. When you have this cup up here and you're doing stuff, you can't see. So to have it down here and still be gravity fed is pretty neat. If you're doing something that doesn't require a lot of paint, this is a great way to go. And they actually even have smaller cups than this. But if you're doing a lot and you need a greater amount of paint, you're gonna have this. So this gun comes with all the bells and whistles, everything you need. And this is a single action. It's just when you push it, paint and air is going to come out at the same time. They have other ones where if you just push it, air is going to come out, and as soon as you pull back on the trigger, you're going to get paint and air. And then there's different ways to adjust how much paint you're getting with this little nozzle right here, and it's moving the needle that's inside either forward or back to allow you to make less paint or more paint. And also from keeping your hand either closer to the medium or away, that's how much paint is going to be there. So I definitely recommend just YouTubing intro to paintbrushing, how to paintbrush, stuff like that. And like I said, this is the brush that they recommended that I get. Then they told me you got to get an air compressor to go with it because there's no way to get the air through. So I bought a pancake air compressor, but I went a little overboard. This is a Craftsman six gallon, goes up to 150 pounds pressure. I'm not gonna need all that pressure. Maybe 30, 35, what I'm reading. But the great thing about this is if you have power tools that require air, like, you know, air drills, air hammers, air whatever, this is gonna be great just to have in a garage with tools. It's got two ports for two different guns. So this was $99 on sale. So this is what I bought. Now, when I got the air compressor and I got the gun and I said, okay, let's see if they fit together, I was sad to find out that they don't. And I'll show you why. I have so many boxes here, I gotta find which box it's in. Bear with me. Okay. So here's the hose that the paintbrush comes with. So you screw this little end down on the bottom, and then this gets screwed into the air compressor. Now the air compressor has these two nozzles. I took one off. You can see the problem. They don't fit together. So I had to go to Lowe's and buy this little guy. So with this little guy, he screws in to the cable for the paint gun, and then this I'm gonna put back on the tool. And this goes here, you pull back on here, you stick that in, and now this will actually go back in here. I'm not gonna do that right now, but that's how that works. So I've got the right adapter. But I wanted to be sure, and I also wanted a longer hose, so I also bought this. This has got a whole bunch of adapters. It's got a longer hose. It's got that cool thing that just shoots just regular air. So that's cool. So happy to have this, and if I need any other adapters, I believe they're all here. So that's another little thing I got. What else did I get? Oh, I also bought a male-to-male just in case, because this one did not come in that kit. I also got this. Now, this is used for cleaning your airbrush. One thing about the airbrush that they're telling me is that after you use it, you have to clean the crap out of it. Take it apart, all the pieces. You're going to shoot the thinner in there and get it all clean. So you need to have one of these. I also got all the little brushes that come with it, different sized little brushes. This thing came with it too. This looks like a pointy needle that's probably gonna get used to clean something. Gotta figure all this stuff out, people. Not sure. Came with these little swabs. Okay, so that's all about cleaning. In addition to the cleaning, I've got a cleaning solvent, which is this. So that's another big thing about the cleaning. All of this is on Amazon. All right, what's next? I don't wanna keep, drop something. I don't wanna keep this in this box. So I was at Harbor Freight today and they have these cool little ammo boxes. So I'm gonna make one of these ammo boxes for all of my airbrush equipment that's gonna go in here. So I thought that was cool. And I have a second one here. I'm not sure what's gonna go in here yet. Maybe the paints, but I've got another airbrush, another box. Okay, what's next? Speaking of cleaning, when I watched the cleaning videos, they were using like pipe cleaners, so I got a whole bunch of pipe cleaners, more with cleaning. I got some magnets, that's for something else that's coming up. I've got a piece of plastic, which is kind of like armor, but it's just flat. When I practice, which I'm also going to use this, just some regular paper. I'm going to learn how to airbrush, and I'm going to practice on paper, and then I'm going to practice on this plastic, similar to armor. The other cool thing is when I bought my air gun, I forgot to talk about this. There's a little lessons for beginners in the book, in the box. And when I bought my cleaner, I think it was, this came with it also. And you can see the two different types of airbrushes there. The airbrush gun that I bought was maybe $25 or $30. They make some airbrush guns that are hundreds of dollars. You don't need all that. Here's the book that came with the compressor. So eventually, maybe if I get really good at this, I'll upgrade my airbrush into one of the more expensive ones. But for now, that I think that gun's going to be okay. So what else did I get? I told you I was going to practice. So I need an easel. So I bought this little easel just to put on the kitchen table. And then I went to Michael's and they were half price. So I was pissed off. And this is neat. A paint mixer. So it runs off batteries and you can put it in your little bottle and zzzz, it'll mix the paint for you. Okay, what else? This is some tape to start to mask if you want to, you know, block off some areas where you don't want to get paint. These are little like test tubes where you can suck up paint and just drop in and mix your paint, because sometimes you don't want to use just the color of the real paint. You want to mix colors. So I got these to try to mix some colors. They were like 75 cents each at a little RC car place. That's where I got a lot of stuff with the paint, is at the RC car place. We don't have a lot of paint supply stores in this area, other than like Michael's and AC Moore. There's no airbrush store that I know of. But the thing that I found out, which is the biggest, coolest thing of the day, was that you can put pretty much any paint in an airbrush. I thought it was a special kind of paint. It's not. This happens to be Testers. There's Humbrol. You can take spray paint, spray it into a jar so it pulls up, and use that paint. The thing is, the paint is thick, so it has to be thinned. So what you have to do is you buy your paint and you buy a thinner and you combine them to a consistency, they're saying, of like skim milk, and then you know that's okay to go through your gun. If it starts to clog up your gun and sputter, your paint is too thick. So I'm sure there's going to be a learning curve of making the right mix so that I can mix it properly. Now, another thing I just learned is you have to have the right thinner for the type of paint that you have. There are water-based paints, there are enamels, there are acrylics, so the thinner has to match the paint you're using. This happens to be enamel, so I have an enamel thinner, and they're gonna work fine together. I happen to get a yellow, a gray, and a rust color. What I'm gonna try to do, once I get a little more confident, I would like to put a little bit of rust on my clone, like around the ears and stuff, and maybe even a little gray or black into the cheeks and stuff. I have great weathering, but I feel like if I could airbrush some weathering in there, it would just crank it up a notch. So I'm excited to get good with the airbrushing, and hopefully I can add these colors. Now for practice, I just wanted to get a black, just a regular black, and this actually says airbrush on it. And this is water-based, so I can mix this with water. Some of the paints, you don't have to mix at all. They come kind of like already in the right consistency. And all of these paints I got at a RC store. And Michael sells the testers. Every art store sells testers paint because there's always models. Now, for masking, there's a liquid mask that you can buy. I'm going to eventually get this brand called Humbrol. What's it called? I have a picture of it on the phone. Humbrol Maskol. M-A-S-K-O-L, I believe. None of the stores around here sell that particular one, but they have this one called Micromask. It's the same stuff in theory. I'm going to try this one first. And what it is you paint it on with a paintbrush, and then it'll get like a rubber consistency. And then when you paint over it, you peel back the rubber, and it will reveal whatever is underneath. So let's say I wanted a layer of silver. Put the whole thing down silver. You cover it up with this, and then maybe put another layer on top. Let's say, I don't know, green. Now you pull back on the rubber, you're gonna have a green piece, but little bits of silver where the paint didn't get to touch. I have a feeling they're both exactly the same. It's probably personal preference. I did find out that Trooper Bay sells the Maskol. It's probably $6.99 or so. So I will be getting some of that as well, because I do wanna try them both in my practicing and see which one works better, okay? So you're gonna need that if you're doing any kind of liquid masking. What else? Let me make sure I save my receipts. This was just something cool. I have a Dremel, but this little, basically a mini Dremel was on sale for like $9. And I was like, it's smaller, it's handy. Maybe I can keep it in the house without having to go to the basement and use my big Dremel. So I just got that just because it was cool and it was cheap. It'll probably burn out. Eye protection, because I needed it. I just can't find mine. Some gloves. I've decided I'm going to wear gloves when I do this painting and touch stuff because I'm tired of getting paint all over myself. I needed another one of these, so that's, you can never have too many of those. And the last thing is, I've got a lot of bolts and nuts and screws and stuff that are just in, like, Ziploc bags. I want to get more organized, so I have this. The last thing. For fine detail, right, so I'm going to do all the airbrushing, but there's going to be some stuff that I'm going to want to do with a brush, and it's tiny, like tiny. So in some of the videos, they were using a rubber paintbrush. Sorry, I keep getting so close. They were using a rubber paintbrush. And what's great about it, and what I noticed, is when they would touch the brush to the medium, it didn't flare out. You know, you can grab the tiniest of paintbrushes, but as soon as you touch and put pressure, it's still going to fan out, right? But with a rubber one, it stays fine. And you can use dots and you can do amazing things. So I've been searching all of these stores for rubber paintbrushes. Guess what? They don't sell rubber paintbrushes, at least not that I could see. But what I did find was these CraftSmart. This was in Michael's, and these are sculpting clay shapers, okay? They used to make sculpt clay and Sculpey and different things like that, and these are made of rubber. And let me cut this open. Uh-oh, sorry, moving the camera. Now I got a scissor right here. This is the boy I really wanted. I'll try to focus if I can. Doesn't want to focus. Maybe if I get out of the shot. Well, either way, it is a rubber paintbrush. And I'm also doing some, modeling my little models. So if you can just imagine, here's a little cloner. Let's say I want it, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to take this guy and put blue on him and make him a 501st Trooper. But if I take this little brush, and I want to put that teeny little bit of blue right there. This is a perfect brush to do that. I found that all my other little brushes that are real brushes just I never get the fine line that I really want. So I'm very, very happy that I found this. And this was about $6 for all of these. Come in different widths. They look like they're mostly wedges, but this is gonna be the one I use the most. So that's it. I'm gonna teach myself how to airbrush. I'm scared, I'm excited, and I'm hoping that I get kind of good at this because it's gonna be valuable to me, it'll be fun, and I'm gonna need it. I'm gonna need it because I have a project coming up. I don't really wanna talk about the project right now, but I will give you a hint of what it's gonna be. Some of you already know, but let's just leave it at this. YouTube fam, I was just watching that video again and I realized I made an error. When I was saying that my gun has the ability to be both gravity and siphon fed at the same time, that's wrong. When I attach that little cup off to the side and down, yes, it looks like a gravity cup, but because it is coming from below and getting sucked up, it still makes it a siphoned cup because the gun has to pull it up from below. So, gravity looking cup, but still siphon fed. Sorry, made a mistake.